What's up, everyone? God bless. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're at, whenever you're watching this video. More Colossians. More Colossians. We're going to start here at verse 9. We did verse 5 and 6 in my last video, and we're going to do verse 9 through almost the end. And I'm just going to read and then talk as I feel led to talk, right? Praise God, the gospel of our salvation, hallelujah, that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and on the third day rose from the dead for our justification. Praise God. Praise God. It's all about what Jesus Christ did, and we are justified by faith. We have peace with God by faith. We have been redeemed by the blood by faith in it. Hallelujah. It's all about the blood of Jesus Christ, and we are saved by grace through faith. Nothing that we do. So now that we've got the armor on, now that we've got Christ, we are clothed in Christ and we are complete in Christ. Now that we've got him on, let's read the word in Christ. Praise God. Verse 9, for this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. A lot of that points to faith, believing. The John 6:40 says that this is the will of the Father, that we will believe on him whom he has sent. Ephesians elaborates on that in different layers and details, that the will of God is to bring everything into Christ in heaven and in earth. So when we have believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, we have done the will of God and we are in the will of God. Because we have believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, we are saved, hallelujah, and we are baptized into him, his body, baptized into a death and alive unto God through him. We are in the body of Christ, and Christ is our head. Therefore, we are in Christ, which Ephesians talk about, to bring all things into Christ in heaven and earth is the will of God. So we are in the will of God, and that's just happening. We don't have to force it. We don't have to tell Jesus in us what to do and what we need. We can rest in the finished work of Jesus Christ and know that God has got us. Praise God. So this desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, or in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, just gives a further revelation of Jesus Christ and the headship of Jesus Christ and how complete we are in him and how safe we are and how much joy we can have in him and what is set before us. Praise God. And all of these things grow us and root us in truth and in love, which is Jesus Christ. Praise God. So it has nothing to do, this next verse, excuse me, let's read it, okay? That ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. This is not something that we do of our own strength. This is what the gospel having free reign in our hearts will cause us to rest and walk by faith, knowing that God has got it and he's in control, and the finished work of Jesus Christ truly is enough. And we are admonished to walk in these spiritual truths, if that makes sense, like these positional truths, excuse me. We're encouraged to walk with our minds set on these positional truths. Does that make sense? It's not a work of, okay, I've got to look around and make sure that I know what God's will is for my life and what I'm doing. Okay, it's God's will for me to open a restaurant and preach to people while they order food. No, that's not it. The will of God is that we would believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and everything would be headed up in Christ, that he would bring all things into Christ. Praise God. So growing in that knowledge and walking worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, to me, is having our minds set on these positional truths and trusting the Lord, letting him reveal everything to us, which, by the way, will be in accordance to the word. We check scripture with scripture. We check thoughts and emotions with scripture. Praise God, because the word stands, yo. The word stands. These videos that I do, they are not, or some of these, they're not in response to anything. I'm just preaching as I feel led to preach. I'm not looking at any videos or any drama on Facebook. I'm keeping my head down and hidden in Christ because I know the weakness in the flesh that wants to go and investigate, to be in the know of like, ooh, what's going on? What's going on? How can I blah, 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 blah. Do you see, like, that to me is the flesh trying to pull, and that spirits, evil spirits, trying to deceive people and carry people off. And praise God, we can discern these things. And I want to stay hidden in Christ and continue to just look at the word and ignore all the noise. You know what I'm saying? So being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. I see those things kind of go hand in hand. When we increase in the knowledge of God, when our minds are being renewed in positional truths, that we have peace with God, that we are children of God by faith, hallelujah, that the blood has satisfied everything, and we can approach boldly to the throne of grace and receive mercy right now, and it's all by faith, praise God, that we are complete in Christ, that we are clothed in Christ, and that we can know that we are in the will of God because we have believed. What a burden lifter that is, because it points to Christ, because it is Jesus Christ. So I see those things as being one and the same, an admonishment to continue to have our minds set on positional truths. All right, so we're going to leave that there. And I like this verse 11, which it kind of made me giggle a little bit, but it says, so for the end of verse 10, increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might. Oh, we're strengthened with all might to go do a bunch of stuff. Now let's read the rest of it. According to his glorious power, unto all patience and long suffering with joyfulness. So we are strengthened, and Christ is revealed to us to get that vision so that we can continue to be renewed and encouraged and strengthened and rooted and grounded in the faith while we are suffering here, because we know that that's what's going to happen. And it just happens. It's to bring us a revelation of Christ for so we can lean on God and let go of the old man. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's great. Strengthen with all might according to his glorious power. Again, he is strengthening us, and it's unto all patience and long suffering with joyfulness, so that we would continue as we gain this revelation to be strengthened in the inner man by his Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. And walk with patience by faith. Praise God. Giving thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Praise God. We are partakers of the inheritance the moment that we believe that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and arose again. Praise God. Verse 13, here we go. Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness. Praise God. Oh my goodness. And hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. We have been translated. We have been moved. We have been moved over and transferred. Yo, praise God. That is a done deal the moment you believe in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, the gospel of our salvation. That happens. Done. Again, with the whole, like the video that I made, the last one about the reservation. It's like, you don't keep calling the restaurant and being like, hey, do I still have it? Hey, do I still have it? You're not going to be looking forward to going to dinner. Like, say it's an anniversary dinner. You're not going to be looking forward to that anniversary dinner with joy. You're going to be looking at it with fear and doubt and worry. You can be like, oh, do I still have my reservation? Am I going to be able to be seated and fed? Yes. Because it's all by faith that we are saved. We can look forward to everything with joy. Because it's just going to be joy and awesomeness, dude. Because everything that isn't Christ is going to be burned off. And that's going to be, oh man, it's going to be, I think it's going to be a good experience, man. Because we're going to see that, and we're going to be like, yes. Oh, why? I was such a fool, but praise God that Christ remains. And now I have more, and I can see him fully and completely. I'm not going to be like, oh, I didn't do enough good works. No, I'm going to be like, praise God that that's over. Praise God, I'm done with that thing down there. The flesh has been, this mortality has been swallowed up in life. Praise God. Oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, it's such joyfulness for us to look forward to. So he has delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. And this dear son, Jesus Christ, verse 14, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, even the forgiveness of sins. Praise God. Praise God. I didn't even come to this video expecting to say this part, but let's keep going because this is where I was going with it. But all this is delicious. This is good, tasty food from the word. Praise God. And this is how we are fed. This is how we drink. Amen. We put that armor on. We understand our position in Christ. And then it's got to all be him in us as we rest. Praise God. Because I don't have any strength. And when I think that I have some strength, I fall on my face. And then I realize I don't want any strength. I want Jesus. Verse 15. So we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principality or powers. All things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. Can you see the totality of everything that is in Christ and how he is just in control? And if we are in Christ, and we are heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ Jesus, we are the bride of Christ, the counterpart to him, to rule and reign with him for eternity. And it is God's good pleasure to show forth his exceeding riches of his grace in kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. And we are just in it, and it's going to happen, and we can trust that. Man, that's pretty peaceful. That's pretty peaceful, I got to say. That's pretty peaceful. That's nice to just sit and think on that and be like, oh, yeah, you got it, Jesus. You done it. You did it. I can trust you. Verse 18. And he is the head of the body, the church. We are the body. The moment we believe that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and rose again. I know I keep saying it, but that's the gospel, and we're going to stand on it. Praise God. He is the head. He is the head, and we are the body. We don't have to worry about anything, man. The head ministers. The head nourishes. We abide in him. He is the vine and we are the branch. He does it. His life, as we just sit there and eat and drink, we're the little branch, water and food and deliciousness being nourished to us by the vine, Christ, the head, we the body. And then this fruit comes out and we're like, oh, that's nice. Thank you, Jesus. Not, look at this apple that I have produced myself. I am such a strong branch. No, praise God. Every time fruit comes out, I want to say praise God. And that only came because I rested in the finished work of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. It's all him. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. And he's already full and complete. We don't have to bring forth fullness and completeness and bring it to him and say, hey, look at this. I'm adding to you. Is this good? No, we can trust that he is the fullness and he will minister and nourish us at perfect timing in perfect ways. Praise the Lord. And having, oh, this is good. This is good, ladies and gentlemen. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, he made peace by him to reconcile all things unto himself. By him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. Now, who's reconciled? And you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled. And how did he do it? By the blood, through the blood of his cross, his death, his burial, and his resurrection. That's how he created peace. And he reconciled all things to himself. And we are reconciled to him by faith. Hallelujah. In the body of his flesh through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. Now, in context, this is of this whole thing, appointing to the sufficiency of God. Praise the Lord. He is the one who did this. He reconciled all things to himself through the blood of his cross, by his death, burial, and his resurrection. And he has presented us holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If you continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel. I read this verse 22. It's the power of God still doing it. Hallelujah. And it is according to our conscience, right? This is pertaining to the conscience. Because if our conscience is damaged and defiled, we're not going to have assurance of salvation, even though that's what the word gives. People might try to lead us astray. The enemy might try to talk doctrines of demons to us. Anyone that's preaching any other gospel, let them be accursed. Because this, the gospel of salvation, gives us assurance. It is the power of God unto salvation, is foolishness to them that are perishing. Because it is all about the blood of Jesus Christ. And it is his power, as it said in 1 Peter. It is the power of God that keeps us. Oh, praise the Lord. I just opened right to it. One page. Verse 5 of 1 Peter, who are kept by the power of God, how? But through faith, unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. We are kept by the power of God through faith. So this says that we continue, if we continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel, which ye have heard. and which was preached to every creature, which is under heaven, whereof Paul, I, Paul, am made a minister. As we grow and are rooted in the gospel, being not moved away from it, our conscience will continually and more completely readily be satisfied by the blood of Jesus Christ alone. And we will come to the Lord in boldness, knowing the blood of Christ speaks for us in the presence of God. We will come by faith and say, "Ah, praise God, praise God, praise God." Whatever you want to say, man, it's praise God, because it's praise God for everything that he has done. Not if has are the things that I've done good enough. God, are you going to let me in yet? That's not how it is. Praise the Lord that he has reconciled us. Everyone who believes, he's reconciled the world to himself through the blood of his cross, and we just believe. We come by faith. Praise the Lord. I'm not going to keep belaboring that point. I think you guys understand it. It is the power of God unto salvation. It is the power of God that is keeping us by faith, and he is the one, as we rest in the gospel, being rooted and growing in the gospel, being moved not away from it, he is the one who is presenting us holy and unblameable and unreprovable. We do not have to tell Jesus how to clean us. We have to remember that we have already been washed by the blood, hallelujah, and purchased by the blood. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, again, gonna move on now. Who now rejoice in my sufferings for you, verse 24, and fill up that which is behind of the afflictions of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church, for his body's sake, which is the church. For whereof I am made a minister, according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God. He's made a minister. What is that ministry? As he talks about in Corinthians, it's the ministry of reconciliation. He's showing us the headship of Christ. He's showing us the will of God. He's showing us everything in Christ and who we are in him and how we can believe, hallelujah, and have salvation, and how we grow, being not moved away from the hope of the gospel. And he says in Galatians that anyone who preaches another gospel than that which you have received, let them be accursed. And even him, anyone, including myself, anyone, angels, no matter who it is, preaches to you another gospel than the fact that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and rose again, and we are saved by believing that, let them be accursed. Mark and avoid, leave them alone. I know I'm talking so fast. Verse 25 again, whereof I am made a minister of reconciliation, praise God, according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God, even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations, but is now made manifest to his saints. What is this mystery that was hid, but is now revealed? To whom God would make known the mystery. What is the riches? To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ in you. A lot of people who want to bring their own works can't understand this mystery and also just want to steal food out of people's mouths. Because if we can understand that Christ is in us and it's his life that's carrying us, oh, what a burden lifter. Oh, what grace and peace and joy that we can rest in. And enemies of the cross and legalists, they don't understand rest and they don't want us to rest. They don't want us to be fed by Christ because they are starving and they're in unbelief. We can come, hallelujah, and we can be fed. Anytime we make a mistake or there's a situation that we just cannot handle or emotions or feelings arise that we're just like, oh no, Lord, we can run to Christ who is in us immediately. Why? Because we have access by faith. We don't need to clean ourselves up. We remember that we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. We do not have peace with God through our works. And if I read my Bible enough, then the Lord will let me come around. That's not how it works. Even that reading the word, which is a good thing to do. If you approach reading the word from a debt perspective, it's gonna be a bad time. We just talked about that in another video, is to read the word in Christ. To enjoy him, to drink and eat, already knowing, having our armor on, already knowing we have peace with him. I don't want to come to the word and be like, all right, Lord, I need forgiveness, so I'm going to read so that you forgive me. No, I have to remember that I'm already forgiven and I can approach boldly and say, Lord, thank you for your grace. Praise God that it's all about the blood of Jesus Christ and I'm purchased by the blood. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are my good shepherd and you are leading me beside still waters. You are leading me into green pastures from which I can rest and eat and drink and graze. Graze on the tasty snacks and meat in the word. This mystery is Christ in us. Brothers and sisters, you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, his death, burial, and his resurrection. Christ is in you. Done deal. Nothing can change that. And you can come and you can rest. Even if your situation or your feelings or your circumstances don't change according to our own timing that we want them to change, you can still wait and trust God because Jesus is in you and he is your life. That cannot be damaged. That cannot be tarnished because that's that inheritance that is reserved for us in heaven, undefiled, that fadeth not away. It's incorruptible and it's in us. We're tasting this treasure in the earthen vessel. We can trust God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Verse 28, whom we preach, Christ in you, the hope of glory, whom we preach Christ. Amen, amen. We preach Christ, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, not worldly wisdom according to emotions, feelings, experiences, or whatever else, show of the flesh. No, teaching people of Christ and showing them who they are in him and everything that he is in them and what he has accomplished and expounding on the gospel and preaching the gospel and the meat thereof, praise God, which is all Christ, so that we can grow in the knowledge of Jesus Christ unto wisdom and spiritual understanding. This is of Jesus Christ, that we may present every man perfect in Christ. I read this as pertaining to the conscience so that we can continually come boldly to the throne and not shrink back by the deceitfulness of sin. No, we make a mistake. We don't shrink back and try to clean ourselves up. We come and know that we are clean by the blood of Jesus Christ. And it's not about what we do. It's all about what he has done. Praise God. Whereunto I also labor, striving according to his working, which worketh in me mightily. His working in me, which works mightily. It all points to Jesus Christ. That is fantastic news. Dun, 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 dun. Channel 8 breaking news. It's all about Jesus Christ, and you can rest in that. Praise the Lord. All right, God bless y'all. I pray this message was a blessing. Christ in us, the hope of glory. Christ is in us. We can rest in his finished work and be not moved away from the hope of God, hope of the gospel. We have a joy set before us, knowing that we have peace with God and our reservation is secure. We can look forward with joy, knowing we are safe and secure and that God is in control. We don't need to keep calling and being like, is it still there? We have a reservation already. It's there. It's done. The moment we believe that Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and rose again. Hallelujah and praise God. Eternal security. Oh, it's good, good news. Now we preach Christ and him crucified. Amen. All right. Peace out.